Hi, I'm Woodpecker. Today I'm going to show you how and why I modified those two morse tapers. I have had this not so bad wood lathe since I moved inside my new shop. But this doesn't mean I know how to use it properly. But there's one thing that bugs me. When I want to remove my life center, I have to use a piece of wood and a mallet. This doesn't always finish well. But I'm still lucky. This life center is made out of one piece of metal, unlike my drill chuck. So, when I try to remove it from the lathe, the morse taper stays inside the tailstock. The only way I figure how to remove it is by taking apart the tailstock. I have to take care not to drop this on the ground with the shavings, because this adds a lot of time to the whole process. But I'm not done. I still have to continue opening it. When I'm done, I use a screwdriver and push the morse taper out of its place. But I'm not done yet. I still have to put everything back in place. I'm more than fed up with that. This is the reason why I want to modify both my morse tapers. I'm going to drill a hole right here in their middle. The first thing I have to do is slow down the lathe to its slowest speed. Then I drill a small hole. When it's deep enough, I switch for a bigger bit and drill it again. In the end, I used 6 drill bits to get the hole to the size I want. But now I'm able to tap the hole. This takes a while. I have to turn half a turn and go back before doing it all over again. And all of this without forgetting to put cutting oils from time to time. When I'm done, I move the drill chuck on the other morse taper and redo the same operations on the other taper. When I'm done, I can use my brand new thread to remove the taper. I just have to screw a bolt and remove it with a hammer. Okay, it's working, but I damaged my lathe in the process. I really don't like that. I'll do something to help me remove the taper. I begin by measuring the distance between the tip of the taper and the base of the tailstock. Next, I cut some wood. This small piece will end up right here, just like that. But before gluing it in place, I find the center of the taper. This damages the wood just enough so I can mark it better and drill a hole. Now I can glue both pieces together. I use my workbench as a clamp. When the glue is dry enough, I try this on the lathe. It's working fine. But if you're an expert on the lathe, you should be laughing right now, because no longer than 5 minutes after I finish this, and just by chance, I found a much easier way to remove the taper. Yes, by the lathe's vibrations, the screw at the end of the life center unscrewed itself, and with that, when I bring back the cone, it's getting loose by itself. All this work for nothing. So I just add a screw at the end of my drill chuck taper, and I'm done. So now you can either modify your morse taper the hard way, or the easy way. It's your choice. But above all, don't forget to come back to the Woodpecker.